7 o'clock. I'm Katie Brethwick.
The Orchestra of Opera North, Classic FM's orchestra in Yorkshire, live in Huddersfield Town Hall this Thursday night. Beethoven's Violin Concerto and Egmont Overture. And Tchaikovsky's Symphony No. 4. The Orchestra of Opera North.
So, I really light the light over the in the morning, and I'm going to use that as my reference for light.
I come and had a look on Friday, and sort of sketched it out, decided to do it. I've had a couple of days on it now, so I haven't done much.
Yeah, I'm working in pencil and paint together.
Which tree is it? Oh, here.
No, I like to have it side on.
It's never really occurred to me.
Start with a cup of tea, and I sit down and think about it, because it's going to last for 2 or 3 days. So it's got to be something that's got some interest in it and trying to challenge. And then I think about what I might be doing with it. And how it's going to fit on the paper, because otherwise you can end up with just working it and it just doesn't fit on. So if you do a general plan and go for the general width of it first, because that's going to be where it fits, and then work out how big the trunk is in comparison to that, then you can start to work. And really, I should take it off the paper to make it fit, but I'm taking liberties with it and changing it. So I painted something called Liquitex, which is, I haven't seen it in this country. And it's like watercolours. You can take a little bit of the stain, and it's so saturated that you can reduce it down. Or you can have something that's much more subtle and allows itself to be glazed rather better than watercolour, actually. It's basically, the technical term is wash, splosh. The light changes, the weather changes, you run out of tea, you know. The exhibition's up for 3 or 4 days at the end of the month.
Oh, right.
The last 2 days of this month, and I think the first two in October. Then I'm going to exhibit it again in Cambridge. Some of the time I live in Cambridge. Some of the time I live in Brittany. And some of the time in New York. Well, drawing is easier to talk to people and work as well. You know, nobody means you any harm. I had a chap on Saturday. He was here for nearly 3 hours talking about his life. And I just sat down and my eyes rolled backwards, basically.
You have a little something in your first glass?
No, I don't actually. Just tea. He's admiring my sandwiches. He's packing at the colours.
What's his favourite colour?
Well, he just had a go at the orange. The cadmium seems to be big with ducks this year.
Splash of blue on the back.
This is just more
really
of the
zoom. Beautiful. Yeah.
It's like walking in a painting.
It is exactly like that. Yeah. Well, it is exactly that.
Yes.
And it only took him 300 years to put it that way.
Yes.
There's a lot of mystery in this place, isn't there? Some little places. I've got to get around the lake and do lots of others.
To be able to be out having a bath, lovely sunshine. Yeah.
It's direct experience that's really wonderful.
I think this place is about to be.
Have you just seen the huge one that's quite
dark? We're trying to count all the circles in to see how old it was.
Oh, did you?
I got to 80. It's probably older than that, actually.
Just grab my son and feed the prison to water.
Oh, he's getting close.
Will your exhibition be local around here? Or?
Yeah, they'll be at the Memorial Hall. Oh, that'd be lovely.
Yes,
awesome.
Yes,
yeah.
See.
Stay down for the walk then. Good boy, eh?
Yes,
See you.
See you.
Going to have an exhibition in the Memorial Hall at the end of the month. The last 2 days, I think, of September and the beginning of October. Next to the pub.
Oh, right,
spread
okay.
Eagle.
I can't drink and draw. Isn't it terrible? Oh, I started in June. I had been working from photographs, and it felt very slavish and as though they were dictating the whole thing. And I thought that's silly.
I just thought I'm losing sense of where I'm going with pictures and things.
It's not like working from a photograph, it's totally different.
Did you do the outline of the tree in pencil first? You've got the skeleton there.
I sketched it in, basically.
I mean, I love anything about it, but particularly the bark.
Yes,
I think that's lovely, the
that way. Works.
A critic.
Yeah.
That's that one. So when's this?
Last week.
Watercolour is a very hard work.
There's no two ways about it. But also, I mean, they are very satisfying.
If they come right.
Yeah. I mean, I did one watercolour painting once in the pure, sort of purest conventional traditional sense. Took me 3 days to do it. Mm. But it was nice to do it.
Yeah.
But I thought I'm not going to torture myself through life having to do this all the time.
This is pastel, and so if you spray them, you leave the dust, the pastel dust on, yeah, on the paper, and it's trapped in the kind of the lacquer or whatever.
Yeah, yeah,
it is.
Yeah.
That in itself gives a sort of an abrasive, yeah, texture, yeah, which, yeah, which allows you to put quite close colours over the top, mm, and still let them show.
Something about this,
totally
drawn.
That's very kind of you.
Where
was
that
painted? New York State.
New York State. Will you
come? You're welcome.
Lovely to meet you. You say goodbye. I was just going to say, yeah, say goodbye. That was being a really hard bit, saying goodbye, yeah, to, yeah, something that you, you know, it's going to have a nice, I know exactly where it's going.
Good.
So, thank you. Nice to meet you. And when we met you, we went looking to find out about you.
I've heard.
So you were
hiding. We've been wandering,
oh,
out,
right,
just wandering around.
Yeah, I said you were hiding, so I sort of picked up on there. Somebody told me 3 hours.
Well,